Masked Singer fans, it is finally here. The season 11 premiere that we've been talking about every single week for the past now 3 months since season 10 had ended, it is finally here. And it being the premiere episode, it's March 6th, which I don't know if you could tell, it's a big day around here. It is my birthday. Like, it's actually my birthday today. I turn... Don't want to tell you the number. Do I tell people? I don't think I should tell people. You don't need to know the number. Because honestly, as I get older, I realize that the number means absolutely nothing. I am still a kid inside. I've got Legos. I've got a 3D printer that I print random things. I'm more of a kid now than I ever was. Except now I've got more responsibility and I've got a lot of bills I have to pay and a lot of people to take care of, and the stress of that messes you up. But all that being said, to me, a birthday is just a birthday. And so today, I had told you that I was not going to be live, but I would still bring you some kind of content. And so tonight is the Masked Singer. I'm not live right now. This is a recorded message I recorded for you so that you have at least something to go off of, because I feel guilty. Because right now I'm probably out to dinner, or I'm probably at a place called Mango Mango, which is amazing because it's all like, it's shaved mango with mango ice cream and actual pieces of mango. And it's, I can't wait. But it's the morning, and so I figured, let's go ahead and go over everything we know about tonight's episode, the season 11 premiere of The Masked Singer. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe, you turn on notifications, and you give this video a thumbs up. All that being said, before I actually dive into everything, I came home, or I woke up, because this is my work studio, but this is my house. So I came into my studio, my door was closed. I'm trying to figure out why. And my wife's like, oh, to keep Jack out of there, because, you know, Jack was eating your cables, which is 100% correct. I have some very expensive headphone cables. I actually work in radio. I'm a reporter and I do audio. And so I've got expensive equipment. And Mr. Jack, 5 months, is eating every single cable I have. Literally, even down to my drone cables. He's like, hey, I can eat that. So every single day I have to remove all my cables, tie them up and hide them so he doesn't get to them. So I came to my door and what do I see? Well, let me show you. It's my door and boom. A ton of balloons. See, these are pretty neat. They're clear, but they got confetti inside of it. Tons of balloons. And then, whole happy birthday thing. These balloons my parents had given me, but Julia decorated my whole studio. I'm like, this is wonderful because it's the Masked Singer premiere and my birthday, so I get to celebrate. I have all these things, but the funny thing is, Mr. Jack, he loves balloons. He loves everything. He loves to bite things and chew on them. They're his toys and he eats them and I gotta get them out of it. It becomes a pain in the butt. And so, Julia's like, that's why I locked the door. Because this is all just a little playpen for him. And he's been here for 5 minutes and I get him out of here because he's biting the balloons and they're popping. So it's like, buddy, why are you doing that? But my wife put up so many decorations. She even framed, this is my Christmas gift that she actually framed, the Ukrainian stamps. If you don't know, don't worry about it. But that being said, now it's time to get back to the Masked Singer stuff. This season is different, but also not different at the same time. And I don't know how to put this, because I'm really excited for it, but I'm also a little upset. You see, as usual, we usually have the same judges. You usually have Jenny, Nicole, Robin, and Ken, and of course Nick Cannon hosting it. But for this season, which we already knew going into it, Nicole was not coming back. She is doing the West End, which is pretty much the Broadway of the UK. And because of that, it did not meet up with her schedule. And you're probably saying, but couldn't they rescheduled it? Couldn't they done this? Couldn't they do that? It's a very interesting situation on how we actually even got this season of The Masked Singer. You gotta remember what was going on in the summer, last summer, when this was filmed. It was the writer's strike. And because of the writer's strike, they didn't know whether or not they'd be able to film something for this upcoming year. So what they did was, after they finished filming season 10, there was a couple weeks they had off, and then we started even doing videos of like, they're filming 11. Before season 10 even started airing, they started filming season 11. So because they wanted to get another one filmed, but they knew that Nicole had some kind of issue because she already had that contract, they had to find someone else to fill her shoes. And that's where Rita Ora comes in. Now, she's been on The Masked Singer UK for some time and actually was on it originally with Ken. Because all of you know, the first season of The Masked Singer UK, Ken was sent over there to go do it, to kind of launch it. So, jumping forward to now, we've got Rita Ora. She came over in August, we'll say July/August, to film The Masked Singer in the place of Nicole. So it's going to be a little bit different, and she's done plenty of interviews where she talked about how great everyone was and how sweet they were and how she was like, they're such a great group together. She was worried that she wasn't going to be like fitting in, but they said they made her feel like she's home. Remember, she knew everyone already. It's no secret. Remember, she's a singer, so she kind of really hooks in very well with Robin. Then, of course, I'm pretty sure Jenny had interviewed her a few times, once or twice, and then she's worked with Ken. So that works out. And then Nick, just Nick. Nick can get along with anyone. Literally. I've seen him get along with every single person, whether it's on Wild and Out or his other shows. He is just an overall great guy. With a lot of kids, though. Lots of kids. That being said, that is the major change for this upcoming season. And I know what you're saying. Wait a minute, Joey. Every single season, since the very beginning, they have always done something different to the format. What is the big change or the big format switcheroo for this season? And if you didn't see my video yesterday, I hate to be the person to give you this news, but I don't really have a choice. The format is the same. They didn't really have much time to change up. That's where it came from, time and change, my dyslexia. They didn't have much time to really reinvent the wheel for this season. So it's the same thing. You got 5 contestants in group A, 4 in B, 4 in C. They all get 1 wild card each. There'll be a winner, a king or a queen in each of those groups. They make it to the quarterfinals. What am I saying today? I can barely speak. Quarterfinals. Wow, man, that was really hard. And then there'll be one time during this season where we know that someone's going to hit the ding-dong, leave it on bell. Not to spoil it for you, the preview showed that Rita will be hitting it, which will send someone from whatever group, because it only happens once, A, B, or C, all the way to the quarters with the winners of group A, B, and C, and then the rest of the season's 3-2, and then finale. So there isn't any change there, but we are getting a lot of theme nights, a lot of different theme nights, and I'm very excited for it. We have, according to this, we've got Billy Joel, we've got Queen, we've got Wizard of Oz, which is next Wednesday's episode, Transformers, because I think that's how many years, 40 years or whatever it is of Transformers. We've got girl groups and shower anthems. So that's fun. And then I believe we're getting Time of My Life soundtrack and then TV themes. TV themes I kind of like because I think everyone can sing a good TV theme. Just whether or not you know the theme, that's kind of what makes it the difference if you actually like it or not. When it comes to costumes, because we're following exactly the same format as they did in season 10, that means we have 16 contestants. And up to this point, they only officially gave us names and photos for 8 of them. Those 8 are Book, Goldfish, Gumball, Lizard, Lovebird, Starfish, Ugly Sweater, and then the latest one, we have Cleocatra. I'm saying it right this time, Cleocatra. The reason why I'm saying it like that is because it truly was kind of hard. I keep saying Cleopatra since that is the real name. When it comes to the premiere episode, though, we only see 5. So we've got Book, we've got Goldfish, We've got Lovebird, Starfish, and Ugly Sweater. Those are the only five you're seeing in this episode. Obviously, we'll have Group A for 3 weeks. So there'll be five on this week. Then we have Wild Card that comes in either on the second episode or third episode. So you potentially have five again next week. Then four, and then whatever is left to be revealed on that third episode. So, you know, once again, it's a little different. I'm expecting to get a double elimination. Not sure if that's going to happen in the premiere episode or the second episode, because that's kind of what happened last season. Just kind of work that out. Though, we'll talk about tonight's episode in a second, just because we already know a lot of information leading up to this, and I don't want to spoil it just yet. All that being said, the other costumes include, like, costumes like the Beats, where there's two of them, and we technically don't have official names for those costumes yet, but we know there are 16, which means they're going to be releasing these slowly. Maybe as they get closer to those groups, maybe just to kind of like keep it fresh instead of releasing them all at once. I know they've been kind of changing that up a little bit. I don't know how I feel about that. You can kind of let me know what you think about that. When it comes to the costumes, we did get a master list of clues. This is nothing too crazy because as we're learning this master list of clues, they really don't help us. I think Fox has kind of given up on that. But it says here they have a combined total of 22 Grammy nominations, 11 platinum albums, 33 Teen Choice nominations, 108 million records sold, 1.7 billion Spotify streams, and 326 film appearances. If that helps you, then do it. I suggest that you write that number down. You have it hidden somewhere. So when you're starting to reveal people, and you have your master list of people, and maybe you only have like two Grammy nominations left, and the people you've guessed all have 10 or more, and you have one person with two, then there's your winner. To me, that's the main reason why you would want to keep that list around. Though, in years past, it really hasn't helped anyone anymore. It's kind of one of those things, just like, it is what it is. Leading into the premiere, we've seen a lot of different trailers. I believe there are three official trailers that came out. Interestingly enough, though, not all of them come out on YouTube. They spread them kind of everywhere. There's like even like a private Instagram group where I've seen videos that they sent fans, and I'm like, why can't I find this anywhere else? I think even like a Fox 11 one put their own out. That's where we saw Ms. I'm going to say it wrong. I'm trying to say it right. Cleocatra. Takes a lot of brain to say that one right. And so I figured, let's go ahead and watch these trailers. I'll play them for you because it does give you a really good preview of how the season's going to go.
Let's have fun tonight. Yeah. Wanna have fun tonight? Get on up, girl. Let's go.
Listen up. The Mass Mayhem is back in full swing.
Oh, yeah. This season goes to 11, isn't it?
The Masked Singer is back with a bang.
Let's shake things up.
Rita Ora in the house.
I am so thrilled to be stepping in as season 11 new panelist. So let's go.
We're never stopping.
Join in on the fun with all new incredible themes.
Hey, Optimus Prime. Whoop, whoop.
What are you doing after the show?
Hey! We will rock you.
No, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
Some of my favorite costumes have been on season 11 of The Masked Singer.
Woo! Ugly sweaters, always in style.
There's so many that I want to take home.
Flock's been putting it down since the very beginning.
You have a book.
I'm studying.
You're all going to be excited to see who the book is.
You're ruining the show.
Stand by, I'll give you a few.
The stage is set, the masks are on.
And the competition is fierce.
I'm taking everyone down.
Yo, bring it on.
Don't you cry no more.
Don't think twice. You and I can be together for the brand new season of The Masked Singer.
Welcome to the most anticipated event of the year.
This is the greatest thing ever!
In one of those trailers, unfortunately, the Fox producers, without realizing it, and maybe didn't catch it with the editors, mistakenly revealed who wins the show. And we're going to talk about that at the end of the video, or you can check out my video. I think it was 2 days ago that we talked about it. That being said, when it comes to tonight's performances, we got to hear the Goldfish, and she sings Olivia Rodrigo's Vampire, and my gosh, I mean, I feel like I know who it is, and I'm just waiting for the first clue package to come out to see if my connections to who I think it is what it is. Once again, it's hard when you listen to these voices, like even the gumball, you heard the gumball, I'm like, oh my, I know that, who is that? Anyway, go ahead and check out the Goldfish. I can't play much of it because the last time I uploaded it, they removed it. And I'm like, I'm in the shot. So I'm doing a reaction video. And they're like, no, you're not. And then they put it back online. So take a look at her performance and let me know who you think that is. Vanessa Hudgens, right? We can hear it. Like, at some parts, it sounds 100% like her. Other parts, it doesn't. But this girl's, like, moving her hand. She's trying to sing with her face. You can tell she's trying to, but she can't because she's got a mask over her face. Now, at the time of this recording, those are the only videos we have for tonight. Though, I am pretty much sure that we're going to get other stuff. Like, I know that there was one other video of Rita Ora that she put out while talking to Good Morning America, which you can check out that video on who she guesses is under the mask of the Goldfish.
Based off the voice, it makes me think of Hilary Duff, Lucy Hale, but Goldfish is so dramatic and theatrical. The gold record is for Glee's album that is certified gold. This might be Lea Michele.
Wow, really?
That would be amazing.
I love that guess. I love it.
So keep that guess under your cap as the show is going on. Now that we kind of went through tonight's episode and the season, now it's time for the spoiler alert. If you don't want to know who wins tonight's episode, or if you don't want to know who wins the entire Masked Singer season 11, this is your only warning to get off the app, shut off your computer, and just wait for the show to begin, because right now we're going to lay on a lot of information. So I'll give you a second. Okay, so if you're staying on with me, it's you and I. We're talking about this. It's happening. The Masked Singer gave us in a trailer that the book is going to reveal themselves tonight on the show. We don't know who the book is, but historically, we've only had one other character that ripped off his costume, and that was the Gremlin. But the first episode usually is a big star, so that person could just film that one episode and then get out of there. Last year, Dick Van Dyke, 97 years old, my dyslexia again, 97 years old, came on, sang, danced for us. I mean, it really was a fun time. So who could this one be? Someone who's gotta be so big, they can only come in for the day, only for the day, and then be revealed and get out. We got a couple guesses. I don't really have a guess. I don't want to give a guess at least yet, just because we don't have any clues. So that is the first spoiler. Could be a second reveal. You never know. You just don't know. When it comes to the winner of The Masked Singer, I'm not quite sure if you blame the editors or the producers, but I'm sure that if you just watch it, you don't realize what Fox had put in the commercial. But us, that okay, if you go by the naming of what the judges and so calls for ultimate fans or super fans, we notice a lot of stuff. First of all, there's people that look at what outfits all the judges are wearing, and they can kind of piece together different theme nights. You know, you look at Wizard of Oz, and you see that, I believe, is it Jenny's wearing like a, I think she's wearing the Good Witch outfit or something like that. So you start realizing that stuff and you understand the format. And if you understand the format and the outfits, you kind of understand where we're at. And so in one of these trailers, which is not online anymore, though it is online as, say, a vertical one, which cuts this part out, in it, you can see the gumball taking off his mask. And behind him, is the goldfish. While that's going on, there's also confetti on the ground. You see Nick wearing a tuxedo, someone else wearing a gold thing. And, I mean, that would usually not really mean anything because you could be winning maybe that group. But even then, it doesn't really make much sense because you realize that the gumball and the goldfish are not in the same group. The only time they would ever meet is in the quarterfinals. And in the quarterfinals, there is no confetti. They don't do that for a reveal. You lost, you lost. It is what it is. But when you win the Masked Singer, the confetti cannons, they announce who wins. The confetti cannons go off. You're given the trophy. You kind of step back. And then whoever is in second place comes on stage. You do the final guesses and then the reveal. Then the person who was the winner comes out and they finally do the reveal. So knowing that and looking at everyone's outfits and that the goldfish and the gumball would not meet until the quarterfinals, it is safe to assume that goldfish will win the entire thing. And it's funny too, because if you look at all the promo photos, all you see is the goldfish in like all of them, which kind of points us at, hey, this could be the star of this season. Now we have heard the gumball sing and he's a great singer. We have heard the goldfish sing and she's a great singer. So it makes sense that both of them would be in the finale, which only adds up to the fact that her winning and him taking second place, it makes sense. But I want to know what you think. Let me know in the comment section below. Do you think that goldfish will win it all? Do you think that gumball is going to get second place? I mean, those are things that you have to decide in the comment section. All of this being said, The Masked Singer Season 11 is going to be so much fun. I am looking forward to it, even though we may know who's going to win the whole thing. We still don't know who's under the mask. And that's one thing I think I've always told you guys in all my videos. I could, not to say I could care less who wins, but it's not really as important as guessing who is under the mask. Because you can guess that a character is going to win, but if you don't know who's under the mask, the point of the show is called The Masked Singer. You're trying to figure out who's under the mask. I think the winning aspect of it is just an extra cherry on top for whoever can win like the Golden Mask Trophy. I don't really think that winning really means much. So when it comes down to it, it's how many reveals did you get right? And so far, since episode 1 of season 1 of The Masked Singer, we've only gotten 2 wrong. Only 2. Dr. Drew, I don't have to say, man. I still can't believe I got him wrong. He was one of my guesses, too. And then Joy, I mean, the other one. I mean, yeah, he was one that I don't think, Garcia just didn't even think he'd be on the show. But I'm happy that he did it. So all that being said, please do make sure you subscribe to my channel and you turn on notifications. As we do try to build this YouTube channel, I will bring you the reveals. We'll do pitch correct audio videos. We'll continue with our recaps of the different episodes. We'll do our compilations of all the reveals. So do make sure you follow, you turn on notifications, and you give this video a thumbs up. I'm Joey. Stay safe. I hope that you're enjoying my birthday. Because right now I should be like head first into like a mound of mango. And I can't wait because I love shaved mango. It is honestly so good. Anyway, I'm Joey. Stay safe and sound. I'll see you later, you Masked Singer fans. See ya. Bye.